нашем центре, куда приходит моя семья, можно сказать, это как второй дом.
This center, which my family visits, is like a second home. For every Muslim, it is the place where one can find themselves, both spiritually and materially. You can study the Quran with everyone. There are programs for both children and women. That's the atmosphere which emerged here after many years. The children are engaged in community work. The dates and water for breaking the fast are prepared by the children.
Ukraine is a very interesting country due to its tolerant attitude to different religions and cultures. For historical reasons, we know how to accept and keep heat on our land. The Ukrainian land is very safe for grains of different cultures and nationalities.
Сегодня готовим фасолия, это сирийское национальное блюдо.
Today we are cooking fasulya beans, a Syrian national dish. Yesterday we cooked an Uzbek national dish, pilaf. We've prepared food for 1,400 people, including 200 packs of food for children.
Of course, fasting during Ramadan is a special kind of worship, especially for Crimean Tatars. In times of atheism, when religion was banned, then the fasting of the Crimean Tatars was the only thread that connected us with Islam. The fasting was the most important thing, saved by our parents and grandparents. I remember how since early childhood, everyone, without exception, was waiting for the month of Ramadan. Everyone tried to fast and take part in this month.
In the holy month of Ramadan, we see the beauty of the Ukrainian mosaic, Ukrainian Muslims and Ukrainian Islam. Every day, representatives of different nationalities who profess Islam gather in the mosque of the Islamic Cultural Center. Here we can see Ukrainians, Crimean Tatars, Arabs, Turks, and people from Central Asia and the Caucasus. Different people gather to pray and turn to Almighty Allah. Every night we pray for Ukraine, for the Ukrainian people, and for the Muslims of Ukraine.